moment to locate the exit nearest you. As a courtesy to performers and audience, please silence all cell phones and other electronic devices. Thank you and enjoy the program.
Today, I want to share with you a piano piece by Mendelssohn, Song Without Words, Opus 67, number 2. This piece is in F sharp minor, and it was composed in the 19th century. It is a short and beautiful piece with lots of staccatos and rests. We can use imagination to make up for the musical connotation in the rests. I hope everyone will enjoy it and my performance. Thank you.
Thank you. and has variety of characters, from its long and lyrical theme to its shorter and dance-like motive.
Something we really like about this piece is how the Dvorak is able to take these motives and then he frequently just changes them, like changes their character. So one side it could go from brilliant, and the next it would be just secretive, or the next would be tragic, and another one would be heroic. Thank you for coming, and we hope you enjoy.
Thank you. period, Franz Joseph Haydn's Piano Sonata in C major. This is one of his most famous piano pieces, and it really captures the essence of Haydn's playfulness. The piece is in three movements. The first movement is very conversational and light. I like to think of it as two squirrels talking to each other. One thing I find particularly interesting about this movement is that it's the only piece Haydn ever wrote where he indicated the use of open pedal, which is basically just holding down the pedal. Because the pedal was a very new invention at the time, it might sound a little strange on the modern piano when you first hear it. But you can think of it as a callback to the 18th century that we are celebrating on the piano here today. The second movement is my personal favorite. It is sentimental, lyrical, it's laced with this sadder feeling of longing, and I feel like it's somewhat the perfect piece for autumn. And finally, the third movement is a joke, in the best way, of course. It's spirited and childlike, but the phrases, the thoughts, keep getting interrupted. You'll see what I mean. I hope you follow along with me on this mini journey through the Haydn Sonata, and most of all, I hope you enjoy my performance. Thank you.
Thank you. you for coming to our performance. My name is Sean, and this is Sheena. Tonight, we are going to perform five Dobrin dances, number 1, 2, and 3 by Anton Pershing.
French composer Anton Pershing created five Dobrin dances, a duet for five timpani and cello performed by the Dobrin art group. These dances reflect the lifestyle of Dobrins who communicate through singing in their imaginary language Dobrin. The Ryans express their emotions and daily actions through generations, gestures, and melodies, creating a rich tradition that resembles the living opera across generations.
Thank you. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
coincidental etude, Barocco, and I like this piece because it has a fiery spirit. So yeah, thank you, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. playing Clarinet Concerto No. 2 by Kuzno with pianist and clarinetist Galaxy Su. This piece is composed in the 19th century, and because of its beautiful melody, beautiful phrases, and the interplay between the orchestra and the clarinet, it's, I think, what makes this such a beautiful piece. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
This piece was dedicated to Robert Schumann shortly after Schumann dedicated his Kreisleriana to Chopin. I love this piece because of its contrasting sections, which makes it very enjoyable to learn and to play. So I hope you all enjoy, and thank you for coming.
Thank you.